Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Lab video discussing the fundamentals of temperature sensing design. In this video, we'll discuss the important sensor parameters that should be considered when designing a system. Sensor interface, accuracy, and placement will be discussed in more detail as part of the Introduction to Temperature Sensing video series. Choosing between an analog or digital temperature sensor is an important first step in design, and from there, the specific accuracy requirements of the application can further determine device selection. Once a temperature sensor has been chosen, the placement and layout is equally important to ensuring that all datasheet specifications are met. One of the first things to consider when designing a temperature sensor into your system is whether it should have an analog or digital interface. An analog temperature sensor will require an analog-to-digital converter, ADC, to digitize its output, as well as a lookup table or polynomial to determine the temperature. In contrast, some system designs may work more easily with a digital temperature sensor, which already produces a digitized temperature output. This output can then be read back over various interfaces, such as I2C, UART, or SPI. In addition to these differences in system design, analog temperature sensors may need further gain in offset calibrations to achieve a certain desired accuracy, a process that will be heavily determined by the system ADC. In comparison, digital temperature sensors do not require further calibration to reach datasheet-specified accuracy. Accuracy specifications represent how close the measured temperature is to the true value. System accuracy requirements will usually come from application-specific details. For example, most medical applications require a high standard of accuracy, and human body temperature must be measured within plus or minus 0.2 or 0.1 degrees Celsius. Other systems, such as motor control or over-temperature shutdown mechanisms, may not have the same high accuracy requirements. In these cases, 1 or 2 degrees Celsius may be more than enough for proper operation. Most often, datasheets will represent this as an absolute value relating to the typical and maximum temperature error in degrees Celsius. The following is an example from the TMP-117 datasheet. Across the maximum operating temperature of the TMP-117, the specified absolute accuracy has a typical value of plus or minus 0.1 degrees Celsius, and the testing conditions for this value are listed at the top of the table. It is common for these typical values to have different testing conditions for minimum and maximum values. Here is an example of lower accuracy specifications from the TMP-103 datasheet. Depending on your system accuracy requirements, looking for lower absolute accuracy may be more cost-effective. It is important to note that these absolute accuracy specifications are usually dependent on a temperature range and will also include all relevant testing conditions. These absolute values are also completely self-contained, meaning that they do not rely on further system design in order to be achieved. Carefully choosing sensor placement and package type can improve the accuracy and thermal response time of the system. The primary modes of heat conduction are the die attach pads and the package lead pins. Being able to quickly respond to thermal changes will result in a more accurate reading. Package size will also be an important consideration for thermal response, as well as available board area. The guidelines regarding sensor placement may differ depending on the temperature sensing application, and here we will discuss component as well as ambient temperature monitoring. For effective component temperature sensing, the sensor should be placed as close as possible to the heat source that needs to be monitored. One method to do this is by mounting the temperature sensor directly below the heat source, on the opposite side of the PCB. With this design, vias can be used in place of copper to increase thermal response in the system. However, it is not always feasible to mount the temperature sensor in this way. In this case, the temperature sensor can be placed on the same side of the board, close to the heat source. We recommend using a solid ground plane that extends from the heat source to the temperature sensor, as this will be effective in creating thermal equilibrium between the two ICs. When designing a system for ambient temperature monitoring, it is important to keep the sensor isolated from other heat sources. With a surface-mounted device, it can be difficult to isolate from heat-producing components on the same board. It is important to avoid creating solid ground planes between the sensor and other ICs, as this will cause unintentional heat transfer. One layout method is creating an isolation island around the temperature sensor to minimize heat transfer from other components. Thermal response will be maximized when the island has a smaller thermal mass, and in this case, the island only contains the temperature sensor and bypass capacitor. An alternate method is separating the temperature sensor from the rest of the board with perforations. In summary, this video discussed several important factors that should be considered when designing a temperature sensor into your system. After choosing an appropriate interface and properly understanding your system's accuracy requirements, optimal placement and board design can then be considered. Paying close attention to these fundamentals is an important first step in optimizing your sensor design. Thank you for watching this video on temperature sensing fundamentals.